I know this hat is kind of old and bent out of shape, but I still gotta represent for that ROC. What's up, everybody? It's Luke James, not the singer. If you're an indie artist looking for an album review and some promo, you can hit up Luke at redmattersite.com. And today we're gonna talk about this track that comes to us from DJ Khaled, Future, and Jay-Z. And this one is called I Got the Keys. This one is also off of DJ Khaled's upcoming album called Major Key. And while I'm not the biggest fan of DJ Khaled, as you probably already know, if you saw my review for his last album, and for that song he did with Drake called For Free, I am a big fan of Jay-Z, so I was looking forward to this one, but the whole DJ Khaled involvement kind of had my expectations lowered. Not to mention this one also features Future, who is basically just doing the same shit he does all the time. And on here, he just has one of those repetitive, basic Future hooks where he's just going, I got the keys, 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 I got the keys, 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 over and over. There's some other things thrown in there on the hook as well. But for the most part, there wasn't really anything special happening with that hook. So I didn't like the hook too much. But the beat on this was cool because it sounds like it's centered around this twisting synth, just another banger. And Jay-Z is doing his thing on here, as you expect. He sounds as good as ever, although I do think his flow sounded a little bit off in some parts, like he was trying to cram some words and extra syllables in, but I still liked what he was doing because he's coming through with some of that boss shit. He's talking about how important it is for people to own their own shit, which I took as him talking about the business side of things. And he also brings up how he brags differently than everyone else because his wife is Beyonce. And I mean, come on, that is one hell of a brag that is hard to top. He also goes in a little bit about how he beats court cases in regards to that whole Big Pimpin' fiasco. So I do like that he was on that braggy and boastful shit. Like I said, Jay-Z was just in full boss mode, and he was definitely the best part of this song. Wasn't a big fan of the Future hook, and the beat was just alright. So I feel this one at a 3 out of 5. It's a cool track, nothing mind-blowing. I'm probably not going to be playing it too much, but I think it's worth checking out, and it's decent. But that's just what I thought about this one. You guys check it out for yourself and then hit me up in the comments section to let me know what you think. And make sure you do all that good YouTube and social media stuff, man. Where you like my videos, you share them, you follow me on Twitter, you retweet the videos, and you especially subscribe to my channel. We're getting close to 15K, at which point I'm going to do another FAQ and Q&A video. So let's get there, and I will see you guys next time.